Hello everybody and welcome back to Slime Rancher, where we are still in the business of slime science and getting money to fund our slime science and to also fund our amazing new house. So it's getting there, definitely. But what I'm waiting for with bated breath is for the honey prices to go up. Now let's see how many mint mangoes these guys have left. None. Oh. These guys have carrots left. No, no one has any food. Ah. Okay, so let's go and get food and just feed all of the slimes as much as we can. Lots of cubries. That's good. The mint mangoes need replanting, but that's fine. Or would be if they hadn't all turned to dust. Right, let's go and check the other tree and see if I can quickly replant another one. That meant I left them too long while we were on our adventure. That's why everyone ran out of food as well, because we were on our adventure. No! All the mint mangoes are gone! This is what happens when you go away from the farm for 2 minutes. Okay, well, you know I said I was going to go to the moss blanket to do some treasure cracking. Well, that's what I'm going to have to do right now. At least those guys are fed. Yeah, we'll go and feed all our phosphor slimes and these guys, because they only just got their feeder. We'll turn all the feeders down to slow as well. Yeah, none of them have any mint mangoes left. Okay, quick trip to the moss blanket. Why am I going this way? I have a teleporter. And I need to use it. I really need, like, the proper slime science teleporters, though. Need to be able to make one of those. I have the pink one. And probably the first place I will make it go will be the moss blanket, because that's the hardest to get out of by far. Right, let's run through. Sprint our way through the feral slimes. Makes me wonder what's off the end of there, if I can fly somewhere cool. I look at this game like a jumping puzzle now. I'm like, where can I go? Where can I fly? Where can I use my jetpack? Okay. Jump down the hole. Hello, little puddle slime. I don't think there are mint mangoes here. That's a pogo fruit tree. I read that hologram. The first time I went exploring the moss blanket, I got stuck here, so I constructed a way out. It's just up yonder. Oh, thank you so much for telling me that now. All these years later. Let's go this way. There might be a mint mango down here somewhere. This is like the worst thing ever. Can't believe both trees ran out at the same time. I wasn't even gone that long. And now I'm here in the dark, I can't see anything. Yay, I can make an advanced apiary! Just keep running around. Honey slimes. Mint mangoes quite often are where honey slimes are. I just need one. That's all I need. I do think that was pretty horrible luck, though. And I bet you I'm gonna have horrible luck finding a new one. Do you think there's any around here? We'll try maybe through up here. Where are you? Probably not actually going to be at the top. They'll be at the bottom. I found them here before. Oh, there's a tree with them. Again, they're not grown. Oh, treasure pod. Well, that's cool, if nothing else. I've got an amber slime lamp. Wow, cool. Oh, it's like a, unlocked a blueprint for me. They're too small. Find a different tree. Oh, I've got tar coming now. Those are all mint mango trees up there too. But I couldn't see if I could get one off it. And get on this ledge. Seriously, like, get lost. Get lost. And then I go shoot all these tar. Just because I have nothing better to do right now other than wait for mint mangoes to ripen, so... So there's three kinds of thing here. There's a... See, I'll replenish my water as well, just in case there's more. Which there always will be when there's too many different types of things in one go. In one place. There we are. We're dead. Honey plorts. If I hang around long enough, never know, the gold slime might turn up. Any of you coming off that tree yet? No. There's one that looks pretty ripe. Hang on, let's see if I can get up there. Thank you. I'll go home now. That was all I needed. My whole farm depends on these things. whole entire farm. Depends on mint mangoes. But now I've got to wait for them to grow as well. Right, if I stick it in the one with the sprinkler first, then they should grow quite quickly. And then I'll see if my warp slimes have all, like, disappeared. And if they have, I'll have to get some more. There, hurry up. In the meantime, I'll grab some pogo fruit. And I'll just feed everything pogo fruit. From off the floor. Oh, good grief. Oh, there's still one growing over here, but I think that's the old onions from over there, all dead as well. So as soon as that patch is done, I will be picking it up and growing it in the other one. But that's one thing I need to do, is to keep a little stock of spares that I don't touch. They're just like my seed stock, effectively. And it'll be a cubery, a heartbeat, an odd onion, and a mint mango. So I could do that in one storage thing. And that would basically be my, like, if something runs out, I could get it from there. There's also a mint mango patch. No, it wasn't. It was a heartbeat. But it's not growing anything anywhere. It's not growing anything there anymore at all. Luckily, there was a heartbeat on the floor. So we can grow those again. That fertilizes soil. Why on earth I was picking up honey plorts, I do not know. It's the most ridiculous thing I could have done. Well, let's see what the honey price is like now, shall we? Shall we? Now we've fed no one. I think we still only have one cubery tree as well, and we need more than that. Okay guys, sorry, have some pogo fruits. I'm gonna feed cuberies. I know this is a waste, but I'm gonna feed cuberies to the warp slimes so that they don't run away. So look, they're already getting really agitated. We'll just feed them like 10. Just until their mint mangoes are ready. And then I always forget that there's an entryway through here to get down to the caves. And then we'll just feed the rest of the cuberies out amongst all the different phosphor slimes. So 10 for you. And 10-ish for you. We'll put that down to slow. That one's slow. Yeah, really struggling for the food right now. It's like, I literally went away for a few minutes, it felt like anyway, and everything had gone. So we've got a bunch of pink slimes now, that's good. Oh, warp slimes are right down. Honey slimes are still slowly climbing. Nothing is really at a point where I would want to sell it other than the hunter slimes. I'll go see if I can find some of those. I'll sell that one honey plort though. I'll go and just pick up all the tabby plorts and the hunter plorts from around here. They'll always fetch a high price, I think, because there's quite a few of them. Well, there's not as many of them. Probably miss a few when they're eating chickens, and then they don't either the plort hides or it despawns or anything like that. Those onions are starting to grow, which is cool. even with my tabby plorts, tabby slimes all over them. It's quite nice because they don't eat the veggies, so it's quite a cool idea to have the carnivores in here eating the chickens while you grow food. It means the slimes can't come and get it. But I think now I have enough for another farm. I'm gonna go down the docks and I'm going to... not that I've got any more kewberries growing at the moment. When I have some more kewberries, I'll make a kewberry tree down in the docks. Could do pogo fruit. In fact, I could do another tree up here and I could start doing the onions down there. But I'd rather have the onions next to each other, so no. We'll keep it as it is. Yeah, I'm quite liking the organisation of this now. You can sell 8 hunter plorts at like 60 odd each. That'll give me a decent amount. It's important that those honey plorts go up in price though. See, I knew you'd go up to 300. Grr. I've seen them higher. Right. Oh, you know what I did as well, is I turned the day over. So okay, I've got to be careful with that then. So if I make it a new day, then I'm going to have... Oh, all the food will have grown. That would be actually quite handy. So if I sleep until morning... All the way through. Read my star mail. Oh, Casey's giving me a star mail about Halloween. Hi, Bea. We never really talked about the Halloween party. Now that you're away, I keep thinking of all these times where I didn't have the words. I guess now I finally do. Maybe it's because I know I won't run into you on the street or something. It just makes it all easier. Right, so the Halloween party. I didn't know that you would be there, and I didn't know that you would know I had met someone. Sorry, and I didn't know that you didn't know I had met someone. I should have told you. But you know how it was. We never really moved things forward. I think I got scared that someone got so close to me. It was just easier to create some space. Easier just to focus on music. I wish I could have talked to you then. But you had already left. I guess I have a habit of just missing you. Really missing you. Aww. So the next one is an arch upgrade. Interesting. Let's return to the ranch and we'll try and see. I think I already read that one. Haha. Yes. This is what I have been waiting for. Honey slimes to go above, honey plots to go above 50. I know they might go higher than that, but it's going to take a while, so... Actually, before I go and sell everything, I need to check the food. Because this is what I don't do. I don't remember to check the food, and then we get a bit stuffed for it, like I did last time, so... Let's just make sure. Yeah, of course. Everything's gone. I got loads of mint mangoes. But now we don't have any kewberries at all. Luckily I know where I might be able to find some more. But this is definitely why the next thing I'm going to do is the whole like seed thing. I'm going to be putting, say for example, one single mint mango in here. That is my seed stock of mint mangoes. I'll add another one and that'll be maybe for heartbeats. We've got some heartbeats here. Okay, then there was another one there. I think that was also a kewberry. Maybe actually two, especially if you've got two plots of it. Like, then I would be able to replant both mint mango plots. Then I'm going to need kewberries and also odd onions. I'll go check on the odd onions. If kewberry is the only thing that I need to go and fetch, then that's fine. Just while I'm getting the money together to get this whole silo idea done. Don't tell me the odd onions are gone too. Seriously, you like sleep for one day and everything's gone. Honestly. Right, at least I can feed mint mangoes and heartbeats to things. But this is difficult. How are you supposed to farm when this keeps happening? But yeah, honestly, I might just put another farm up here and in those two slots again. Because I don't really think I want any more slimes than I've got. It's definitely the food that is holding things back. I'm almost certain that all the cubries will have been eaten though. Okay, so give the warp slimes to mint mangoes. They get a bit annoyed when they don't have any. Oh, they're playing with cubries in their cage. Come on. Put mint mangoes in here. They don't like them very much, I don't think. They've all escaped. They want their mint mangoes. Go back in there. I'll take away the cubries. You can have some mint mangoes. They were just an emergency measure. Luckily, now all I have to do is try and find an odd onion. Please stop going away. Splash them with water. Bring them back to their normal selves. Ooh. Yes, be a normal slime. Okay, so I think all we've got outside now are ghosts. I'm just going to up the speed on it a little so it'll give them a few mint mangoes to start with. Go. You happy now? I'm happy. You're hard to count sometimes. Put those back in their cage so that they get sucked up by the auto grabber. Okay. I'm happy now that I at least have cubries to spare, and mint mangoes are being sorted, and I just need to find some odd onions. So I will go and sell the honey plorts. Buy the truckload really quickly. As quickly as I can before the price drops. I have so many of them. 51. That's great. That'll do me. Okay, run. This will be enough to pretty much buy anything I want, hopefully, by the time I'm finished with this. Get all the ones off the floor, get the ones out of there. Okay, I've got another probably couple of runs worth. I think I got about 200 to sell, and I think I've got more in other places too. This is going to crash the price through the floor, but I can do it quickly. Alright, run number 3. Really glad I upped this to 50. This is like 150 of them sold. If they go up to like 60, I'll be kicking myself. But I waited, I bided my time, like I could have sold them when they were 25, they're worth double that now. So I think I was quite patient. Since there's all the ones from this area gone now. And then we need to grab the ones down by the honey booms. Some 51. As soon as I've done this, and it needs to all be done at once. No doubt about that. As soon as I've done this, I will go and sort out the cubery crisis. I want another 100 there. Probably about 250 of these that I've just sold. I think we had... No, we had nearly 100 in the... yeah, it's nearly 300, actually. Honey harvest! Woohoo. I've still got some in the cave as well. Because they're such a docile slime and they have a reasonably high value plort, that's why I want everything to be honey. That's why I ended up with so much and crashed the price. And I'm going to crash the price again, I will have to wait for that to come up. Doesn't matter because I'm milking it for all it's worth. Right, let's see what you guys have got in there. 36. I do need to be better with the cuberies. Just hit that. Maybe the phosphor ones will go up in price as well. A few more left after that, but not many. They can wait till next time. But that was another 50 out of there. So I reckon that's what, 350 honey plorts I've just sold there. And that's got me 18,000. So the first thing I'm going to do with my newfound money before I think I've got all the upgrades. I got them last time. Just make sure there's no more honey plorts like sat around anywhere. No. Okay, so next thing I'm gonna do is basically try and buy all of the blueprints here before I start doing things on the house. I now have the amber lamp as well. So like the advanced drill pump and apiary, I will buy those first. And anything else I think I will want. Probably will want a teleporter, but I don't think I want it quite yet. Warp depot, hydro cannon. I don't think I've ever needed that, and I don't think I ever will. Taming bell might be handy. Pink slime lamp. And an amber. Oh, I got that as a free one. That's pretty cool. A slime stage. Gordo snare. No, I think it's the teleporters that I need the most, and the warp depot probably. To remotely transfer resources between two points. But then most of the time I'm going to be using my inventory for that, so I'll build the teleporter, the first set of teleporters first, and then I'll see how I am. Okay. So I still have 12,000 left after I built all the little bits and bobs there. So I'm going to go and plant my cubery trees so that they can actually start growing, and I'm going to... Do you know what? I'm going to put them here. We need lots of gardens and lots of food, so get them in there, get them upgraded, get those, maybe even put another coral in there and get some other kind of phosphor slime. maybe a phosphor boom or something like that. Because phosphors are generally quite calm, so other than the fact that they fly a little bit. So we get nutrient soil there and a sprinkler. Have another cubery tree here as well. So that would bring me up to 3. Or would it be better to have a mint mango one? I'll put a garden there anyway. But we have a lot of honey based slimes, so mint mango trees are always good for them. And I'll also upgrade the storage. Right, there was meant to be a cubery tree in here. And I'll upgrade that with nutrient soil and a sprinkler. We're gonna get through this money very quickly, I imagine. Got some mint mangoes here. Can feed to everyone. Some on the tree as well. It's a lot quicker if you wait for them to drop, but if I wait for them to drop, then they might run out. Cool. Right, that's all my mint mangoes from there. I'll come back for the hunter and tabby slime plorts. Pop down here. And we'll see what we've got. So, I think we were meant to have a couple of mint mango trees down here. So, 1, 2. I would say by far the largest amount. So, if I have 3 cubery trees and 3 mint mango trees, 1 heartbeat, and 2 odd onion sections, in which I can have I think that would be fine. Because I only need to feed like 2 pens worth of rock slimes, the heartbeats, and I only have 1 crystal slime thing to feed the odd onions to, but I can feed the carrots as an overflow to the rock slimes. And the rest of them all eat fruit. Every single one of them. They're all honey or... they're all based on honey or they're based on phosphor. Right, so we've got all of the slots now. I'm going to put 2 cubries in one. And then I'm going to put 2 odd onions in one as well. And that's everything that we feed our slimes. But for the odd onions, I need to go on a little trip. Unfortunately. That's some more mint mangoes already. Yes, I will need to go on a little trip. But we'll have to do that next episode, and we'll have to go and get some odd onions. And once I've done that, we're not going to have a problem. I want that to be a mint mango tree. What will you exchange for? See, it just doesn't seem worth it. Not for a farm that's doing as much as mine is at the moment. Okay, well, I'll feed the mint mangoes to the warp slimes. And hopefully as I get more of them, then... See, I don't think I've done a very good job of actually just balancing it. I've got all of these slimes and nothing to feed them. So definitely getting to the point now where I'm thinking about... rather than just thinking about, oh, I've got this cool slime and it does this and it does that, I'm actually thinking about the efficiency of it all. So I'm going to feed these guys. They got nothing to eat, so 2 carrots is better than nothing. And you guys can have like 6 or 7 each of those. And that's us on our way. But yeah, so I've got 2 pens of things that take mint mangoes. 1 pen of things that takes that. I probably need another heartbeat garden, I would say. So I'm going to get one more garden, and I'm going to put heartbeats there. But I'm going to do all of this next episode, because I've realised the time, and we are running out of it. So, there we go, we are at level 5. Or do you know what? Why don't we go get that archway? I've been so good at doing things around the farm. I've been so good. So good. different ways I can colour things. Right, well let's just take this one at a time. And appreciate each upgrade as we go. So it's an arch upgrade. Is that an upgrade to the arch over here? Oh yes. Oh, how lovely. We've got a proper gate now. Can we shut it and open it and stuff? Is it shut behind us? I do wonder whether you eventually get electricity or something in all this. Because there's a load of stuff that seems to be hooked up to an electrical grid. So I wonder if we can eventually like gate off parts of the farm and all that sort of thing. Anyway, that is definitely the end of the episode now. So I hope you liked it, and if you did, then please leave me a like below. If you'd like to see more Slime Rancher and see what more things we can get at the 7Z Club, because that is basically what this is becoming, and also what things we can do in Slime Science, then please do subscribe and I'll let you know when the videos are out. I hope to see you next time, but in the meantime, please look after yourselves and keep being awesome.